Okay, welcome again to the final edition of the December's GAinful. This will cover the week from 24th to 30th of December. I hope this should be enough for your clerk mains, which will be taking next week. So I'm on a rampage covering one session after the other. I'll do one more along with the banking awareness, which I know it's everything is included in these four sessions, but still some of you wanted it to be separated. I'll do that. And I'll also collate some extra news if here one and two news on a daily basis, if we found interesting, which we did not maybe, you know, cover in the first go. I have done that already. It's there in the Y quiz. We'll cover that also along with the banking awareness. So that's just one more left with these, first, which I had covered up to 9th and then say 10th to 16th, then 17th to 23rd and this 24th to 30th till your clerk is done. All the PDFs are available in our GAinful drive. Make good use of it. Okay, so without wasting any further time, let me start the session. Okay, National Consumer Day is observed when? The dash anniversary of Sashastra Seema Bal was held in New Delhi. Former Union Minister Captain Jai Narayan Prasad Nishad was from the state of Nirupam Sen, was a veteran. What? The country celebrates the Good Governance Day on what day of December? Let's quickly look at the answers. Okay, National Consumer Day is observed on December 24th. Okay, and why is the need for it? It was to highlight the importance of the consumer movement and the need to make every consumer more aware of their rights and responsibilities. Okay, theme of 2018 is timely disposal of consumer complaints. The Sashastra Seema Bal SSB, it was the 55th anniversary and this was held in New Delhi. Okay. Former Union Minister Captain Jai Narayan Prasad Nishad died at the age of 88. He was MP from Muzaffarpur constituency in Bihar, famous for your lychees. Nirupam Sen, veteran Marxist leader and commerce and industry minister. That was his designation. Commerce and industry minister in Buddhadev Bhattacharjee's government. Passed away in Kolkata. He was 72. Bharat Ratna and former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's birthday is being celebrated as Good Governance Day across the country on December 25th. Okay. Dwijen Mukhopadhyay was a famous what? Which space agency has launched GPS-3 satellite nicknamed Vespucci? Who has been awarded Driver's Driver of the Year? Which country has been hit by devastating tsunami last week? In which state has PM Modi inaugurated several development projects on December 24th? Let's quickly look at the answers. Dwijen Mukhopadhyay, he was veteran Rabindra Sangeet singer. He has sung almost 1,000 songs of Tagore during his lifetime. SpaceX successfully launched the United States Air Force's first GPS-3 satellite nicknamed Vespucci, okay, from Cape Carnival, Florida. Okay, after claiming historic 5th World Driver Championship, Lewis Hamilton has added to an ever-growing list of accolades after taking home the inaugural Drivers Drivers of the Year. Okay, Lewis Hamilton is like, he's on fire. A 10-foot tsunami in Indonesia on December 22nd killed at least 373 people and injured more than 1,459 on the nearby islands of Java and Sumatra. That's what, you know, this happened because of some volcanic activity in the nearby island. Okay, that caused the landslide and then that caused tsunami. PM Modi inaugurated projects worth 15,000 crore in Odisha. Okay, this also includes the setting up of new IIT Bhubaneswar at Aragul. Okay, 1660 crore, going to be a huge, you know, infrastructure. Let's move forward now. What denominations of commemorative coin has PM Modi launched in the honor of former Prime Minister and Bharat Ratna Atal Bihari Vajpayee? Which city is hosting the 6th edition of Yuva Natya Samaro from 22nd to 26th of December? Which city hosted the International Gita Mahotsav? How many monuments have been adopted under central government Adopt a Heritage project so far? How many weightlifters have been banned by the International Weightlifting Federation after being found positive in dope tests? Let's quickly look at the answers now. So, a commemorative 100 rupees coin in the honor of former Prime Minister and Bharat Ratna Atal Bihari Vajpayee at Parliament House next year in New Delhi, 24th of December. Okay, Atal Bihari Vajpayee anniversary celebrated on 25th December as Good Governance Day. Okay, the 6th edition of Yuva Natya Samaro, it happened in New Delhi. Kurukshetra hosted the International Gita Mahotsav 2018. Okay. So they are basically, you know, 10 sites which are already adopted under that Adopter Heritage project. 5 weightlifters, including 2 Olympic champions, have been provisionally suspended. Okay, Bogeyville Bridge is inaugurated in which state? Narendranath Chakravarti was renowned what? Bala Rafzik is associated with. The first music museum of the country would be set up where? Where has the amphibian named Dermophis Donald Trumpy been found? Let's quickly look at the answers now. So, this Bogeyville Bridge, that's a rail cum road bridge, is over Brahmaputra in the district of Dibrugarh, Assam. Okay, that's the 4.9 kilometer long double decker bridge. It's India's longest and Asia's second longest rail cum road bridge. Okay. Famous Bengali poet Narendranath Chakravarti died at the age of 94. So he was a Bengali poet. Bala Rafi clinched Maharashtra Kesari title by defeating Abhijit Katke of Pune 11-3 in one-sided match in wrestling. So we are talking about wrestling here. The country's first music museum would be set up with the assistance from central government in Tiruvayyaru, Tamil Nadu, the birthplace of Saint Tyagaraj, one of the Trinity of Carnatic music. The other two Trinity are Muthuswami Dikshitar and Shyama Sastri. Okay. A newly discovered animal that buries its head in the sand has been named after US President Donald Trump, apparently in response to his comment about climate change. The amphibian Dermophis Donald Trumpy was discovered in Panama. Panama's capital, Panama City. Let's move to the next. Two-time Olympic gold medalist and World Cup alpine skier Michaela Pauline Schifrin is the citizen of which country? Mahesh Mangaonkar and Yash Fateh won a title in which sport? Where was the first meeting of the follow-up committee for implementation of trilateral harbor agreement held? Name the naval hospital ship recently commissioned by the Indian Navy, who is appointed as the new MD and CEO of Corporation Bank. Let's look at the answers here. So that's American, yeah. Michaela Schifrin became the youngest woman to win 50 World Cup ski races with victory in the slalom in the French Alps. The Olympic champion became the first woman to secure a half century of race victories before her 24th birthday. What an achievement. National champion Mahesh Mangaonkar of Maharashtra and Yash Fateh, they have won India's squash championship. Okay, the first meeting of follow-up committee implementation, it has happened actually at the port city of Chabahar in Iran. Okay, Indian Navy Commission, INHS, Indian Naval Hospital Ship, Sandhani. Okay, it's the 10th Naval Hospital at the Naval Station Karanja in Uran near Mumbai. The appointment committee of the cabinet has approved appointment of P.B. Bharati as the managing director and chief executive officer of the Corporation Bank. Okay, let's try these. What is Sadaiv Atal? Which state has started Mukhyamantri Krishi Ashirwad Yojana scheme for farmers? Who has prepared a draft to make changes in the information technology rules to curb the misuse of social media? Dash is the name given to the Child Care Institute in Haryana and named the newly appointed LinkedIn country manager for India. Okay, Sadaiv Atal is a memorial of the former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. It was dedicated to the nation Tuesday on his 94th birth anniversary. It will be managed by a trustee headed by Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan. Jharkhand farmers will get an annual incentive of 5,000 per acre land during Kharif season from the next financial year under new scheme Mukhyamantri Krishi Ashirwad Yojana. That's for Jharkhand. Okay, the government has said it proposes to bring changes in the IT rule to curb misuse of social media and online platform. The draft amendment, as expected, is by the IT ministry. Haryana CM Manohar Lal Khattar announced name all the child care institute being run in the state as Jagannath Ashrams. Okay, so all, since they are all doing the same thing, let them have common name. LinkedIn has appointed Mahesh Narayan as the country manager for India effective January 7th. Okay, let's try these. Which state has started Atal Ayushman Yojana yesterday? Sri Sulagiti Narasamma was a renowned what? Which famous Australian cricketer is inducted into ICC Hall of Fame? Who took over as India's chief boxing coach? And Manju Mehta is a famous what? Let's look at the answers here. Atal Ayushman Uttarakhand Yojana has been launched in the hill station of Uttarakhand. Okay. Now, Padma Shri Sulagiti Narsama passed away at the age of 98. The nonagenarian was honored with Padma Shri in March this year for her role in delivering babies safely. So she is basically a social worker. Former Australian captain Ricky Ponting was formally inducted in ICC Cricket Hall of Fame. Ponting was named in the ICC Cricket Hall of Fame along with former Indian captain Rahul Dravid. Okay, and England woman wicketkeeper Claire Taylor. Dronacharya awardee C.A. Kuttappa has taken over as India's chief boxing coach at the ongoing national camp. Noted sitar player Manju Mehta. So Manju Mehta, she is a sitar player, has been conferred with the Tansen Samman for 2018 by the Madhya Pradesh government for a contribution in the field of music. Let's move forward. Who is the newly appointed deputy MD of ILNFS? Who has launched the book Prince, Patron and Patriarch? Maharaj Jagjit Singh of Kapurthala. Which country has decided to withdraw itself from the International Whaling Commission? Who will head 6-member panel on economic capital framework? Who is Usha Timothy? Let's look. Okay. ILNFS has appointed retired IS officer Vijay Kumar as deputy managing director of the company. Punjab CM Amrinder Singh released the book on the former ruler Maharaj Jagjit Singh of Kapurthala. Japan has decided to withdraw from the International Whaling Commission and will resume commercial whaling July next year. So they'll start killing whales. Okay. Former RBI Governor Bimal Jalan will head the RBI's expert committee to decide the appropriate level of reserves that the regulator should hold. The 6-member panel has former Deputy RBI Governor Rakesh Mohan as its VC and comprises Economic Affairs Secretary Subhash Chandra Garg, RBI Central Board members Bharat Doshi and Sudhir Mankad, and Deputy Governor N.S. Vishwanathan. So this is a very important panel. I think you should remember this. Bimal Jalan name you should know, even the VC Rakesh Mohan you should know. Late music composer Lakshmikant Shantaram Kudalkar and playback singer Usha Timothy. So she is a playback singer, are honored with the Muhammad Rafi Award. Okay, almost she has sung 1,000 songs in multiple Indian languages. Okay, try these. Which zoo has been closed for visitor after the death of peacock from H5N1 virus? Which country has launched its first messaging app named BizBade? The Mount Etna is located where? Which e-commerce company will set up logistic hub as Haringhata in West Bengal? Konu, which was recently notified as national park, is in the state of Dash. Let's look at the answers. Okay, so investigation of into the death of 6 peacock at Sanjay Gandhi Jaivik Udyan in Bihar capital Patna city has led official to conclusion that the deceased bird contracted H5N1 virus and hence it was closed because this is deadly, though it is not easily transmitted. If human become infected, the mortality rate is almost 60%. The repressive Central Asian nation of Turkmenistan, with the likes of FB, WhatsApp, etc., are banned, launched its first messaging app, BizBade. So that's in Turkmenistan. Earthquake magnitude 4.8 on the open-ended Richter scale and 4.9 on the moment magnitude scale, triggered by Mount Etna eruption, jolted eastern Sicily, injuring at least 10 people. Okay, so Mount Etna is an active stratovolcano on the east coast of Sicily, that's in Italy. The Council of Ministers, having given their consent to the proposal by the Flipkart to set the logistic hub at Haringhata at an estimated investment of around 991 crores. So now MP government has notified Konu as the national park in compliance with late last condition imposed by Supreme Court appointed committee for the much waited translocation of Asiatic lions from Gir in Gujarat. So this Gir is special because they are the Asiatic lion in India. That's the only place here. Now you will also find them in MP in Konu National Park. So this Konu, if it comes, is not static. This is clearly a current affair question. Let's move ahead. Hedeyaman is the annual festival of Baduga tribal community of the state of. 14-year-old Arjun Bhati, who is in the news, is what? Which country has tested its first hypersonic missile? How many countries voted in favor of adopting the Global Compact to support world's refugee? After the Netherlands and Canada, which country will become the third to permit the export of medical marijuana? Okay, the tribal Baduga community in the Nilgiri Hills of Tamil Nadu, that's where they are from, is celebrating their annual Hidayaman festival on December 26th. Arjun Bharti, the India's Arjun Bharti, bagged the first position in the US Kids Junior Golf World Championship in Malaysia. He's already playing for 5.5 years. Russian President Vladimir Putin has hailed the final test of hypersonic missile, which he had earlier said would render existing missile system obsolete. So that's a big problem for NATO, and it could fly 20 times the speed of sound. That's hypersonic. An overwhelming number of majority states, 181, voted in favor of adopting compact, with the United Nations and Hungary opposing the move. So what we are talking about, the Global Compact for Migration. Okay, Israel's parliament has unanimously approved a law to permit export of medical marijuana, allowing Israel to tap the lucrative global market. Israeli medical cannabis company ICAN predicts the global industry will reach $33 billion in the next 5 years. Okay. And you also can see this, Thailand has become the first nation in Southeast Asia to allow the use of marijuana for the medical purpose. Okay, Dwijing festival is celebrated in which state? Which state government has approved the implementation of 7th Pay Commission recommendation? Divya Patidar Joshi was crowned Mrs. India 2018. She belongs to which state? Country's first spider interpretation center has been set up where? And which state will have its own high court from Jan 1, 2019? Okay, here are your answers. The third Dwijing festival has begun on 27th December on the bank of Ai River at Chirang district, Assam. The New Year gift, that's from Maharashtra government, that's the implementation of 7th Pay Commission recommendation to over 20 lakh of its employees. The Mrs. India My Entity Beauty pageant won by Divya Patida Joshi, held in Delhi, and she hails from Madhya Pradesh, Ratlam. The Spider Interpretation Center is at Jabalpur, MP. It has took over 20 years and has more than 150 species. Okay. Since the bifurcation of the state in 2014, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, they had a common court at Hyderabad. Now, Telangana, its capital is Hyderabad. It will continue to keep this. This Andhra Pradesh basically will have a new court that will now operate from Amravati, and now country will have 25 high courts. Try these. Who took over as the Deputy Chief of Integrated Defence Staff? Indian skipper Virat Kohli has surpassed which Indian cricketer to make most overseas run in a calendar year? Which district topped the tally in the most improved district category of second delta ranking of the aspirational district? Delta is basically maximum change. Delta is change. Okay. Which Indian American is named as the president of US courier delivery giant FedEx Express? Colin O'Brady, who has become the first person to traverse Antarctica alone, unsupported and unaided, is the citizen of which country? Air Marshal Rajiv Sachdev has, you know, taken over as Deputy Chief of Integrated Defence Staff. Virat Kohli bettered Rahul Dravid's long-standing record of most runs scored by an Indian in a calendar year. Okay. Now, in the Niti Aayog released, yeah, second Delta ranking and the top three improved district category. Yeah, Virudhunagar, Tamil Nadu, Nuapada, Odisha, and Siddharth Nagar, UP. Okay, so just remember this. Indian American Rajesh Subramaniam has been named the president of chief executive officer of US multinational courier delivery giant FedEx Express. He is IIT Bombay graduate from Thiruvananthapuram, has been with FedEx for more than 27 years. Colin O'Brady is a US citizen. He, you know, the 54-day trip across the Antarctica, that's called Antarctica Ultra Marathon, unaided, not supported by, you know, anyone, no support, all on his own. It took him 32 hours and 30 minutes. Name the AI-based robot which will be inducted in Indian Railways to monitor and record the health of train. Name the new state-of-art technology introduced by Indian Railways for enhancement of train safety. In how many cities has the RBI launched a survey to capture the retail payment habits? Professor Hamidi Kashmiri was a renowned figure in the field of what? Where is the 26th National Children's Science Congress inaugurated? Okay, let's look at the answers. Indian Railway, you know, they are launching this undergear surveillance through artificial intelligence assisted droid, or the name is Ustad. Just remember this. Equipped with high definition camera to monitor the parts of rail coaches and transmit the information to authorities in real time over Wi-Fi. Okay. This is the mechanical branch of the Central Railway Nagpur Division has introduced new state of art technology called Automated Train Examination System, ATES, for the enhancement of train safety. The system developed by Konkan Railway Corporation Limited eliminates manual examination of train and measures axle box temperature, wheel disc temperature, and records the undergear of rolling stock of running train through infrared and other cameras. RBI will capture payment habits of individual in 6 cities. Okay, so we are talking about how many? The 4 metropolitan, for the purpose of central bank, has launched survey on retail payment habit of individual. These cities are Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai, Bangalore, and Guwahati. RBI headquarters, Mumbai. Renowned writer, poet, and former vice chancellor of University of Kashmir, Professor Hamidi Kashmiri, easy to remember, Kashmir, professor in Kashmir, passed away at the age of 86. Odisha CM Naveen Patnaik inaugurated 26th National Children Science Congress in Bhubaneswar. Okay. Who has released the Administrative Handbook of Information and Broadcasting Ministry? Minister of Tourism has signed an MOU to develop a mobile audio guided app for how many iconic site? Where was the 41st meeting of Central Sanctioning and Monitoring Committee held? President Ramnath Kovind gave assent to 2 bills, one from Tamil Nadu and the other from which place? Where is the Bahuda Rukar, the new site for nesting of olive red-lay turtles, located? Let's quickly look at the answers. That's going to be Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore. That's the Information and Broadcasting Minister. He released the administrative handbook. Okay. So this mobile audio guided app will be for 5 iconic sites. The Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has approved construction of another 3,10,590 more affordable houses. Right. This meeting, the Central Sanctioning and Monitoring Committee, was held in New Delhi. And the cumulative number of the houses sanctioned under PMAY is now 6854126, 68,54,126. Okay. The 2 bills Ramnath Kovind has given assent to are from Tamil Nadu, aim to create port to maintain and administer public charitable trusts and endowments created by 1 year community members. The other is from HP. Himachal Pradesh Early Childhood Care and Education Center Registration and Regulation Bill 27 aims to ensure quality education to children by providing all basic facilities. Odisha Forest Department is all set to add another olive red-lay mass nesting site to its wildlife map. Okay, who is the PM of Bhutan who recently visited India? With regard to the cabinet decision taken by Government of India, some crore, how many crore, was approved for Gaganyaan program. Name the award which Government of India has instituted to recognize excellent work done by individual and institution in fields of disaster management. Union Home Ministry has banned which organization under Unlawful Activities Act, and Drone Olympics will be hosted where? Let's look at the answers now. Newly elected PM of Bhutan, Lotay Shering, was on his first foreign visit to India. It was a 3-day visit. PM Modi has approved 10,000 crore for Gaganyaan program. Okay, just remember this. Okay, the 3 eligible institution and individuals will be given Subhash Chandra Bose Apada Prabandhan Puraskar. So Apada is disaster, right? So disaster management, this is disaster management award. Okay, every year with cash rewards ranging from 5 to 51 lakh according to the National Disaster Management Authority. The Union Home Minister has banned Khalistan Liberation Force under the provision of the Unlawful Activities Act. In a bid to sample the market of unmanned aerial vehicles, the center is organizing Aero India 2019, which is scheduled to be held in Bangalore. Okay, so the Government of India is organizing a drone Olympic under which various drone competitions shall be held. So that's in Bangalore. Okay, let's try these now. Which business conglomerate has passed Tata Group to become most valuable business house in the country? The government of Nepal said the limit of Nepalese spending of Indian currencies in India per month to what? Name the most profitable PSU public sector undertaking of financial year 18. Who is the Balkan athlete of the year? Culture Minister inaugurated an international seminar to commemorate the birth, okay, anniversary of Sikh philosopher, reformer and freedom fighter Sri Satguru Ramji Singh. So which anniversary was this? Okay, let's look at the answer. Financial services conglomerate HDFC Group has now become the most valuable business house in the country. Okay, now after the crackdown on high value currency, in the last, before the last one, there we heard that, you know, 2,500 and 200 were banned, right? Now they have put Nepali rupee 1 lakh limit, spending limit also. Indian Oil Corporation 13.37% emerges the top three. Okay, so this is Indian Oil Corporation, ONGC and NTPC have emerged top three most profitable PSUs. Okay, while BSNL, Air India and MTNL incurred the highest losses for second consecutive year. I don't know why we are still going with it, what value we are adding. Modric won Balkan Award ahead of Djokovic and Halep, Simona Halep. Modric won the Championship League with Real Madrid and then led Croatia to the World Cup final in July. Very popular figure there. He also won prestigious Ballon d'Or for the first time earlier in December. To commemorate the 200th birth anniversary of Sikh philosopher, reformer and freedom fighter Sri Satguru Ram Singh Ji, an international seminar was inaugurated by Minister of State for Culture Dr. Mahesh Sharma in New Delhi. Okay, let's try these. Who became the new CMD of South Eastern Coalfield Limited? Who is the most admired man according to the Gallup Annual Survey 2018? Who inaugurated 42nd Social Science Congress at KIIT Bhubaneswar? How much amount has been cleared since November under 59 minute scheme in 1000 crore and the government is likely to infuse 28,615 crore in how many PSPs? Okay, Ambika Prasad Panda has been appointed Chairman and Managing Director of South Eastern Coalfield Limited. You should know this is the largest coal producing company in our country. Former President Barack Obama is the most admired man for 11th year in a row. President Donald Trump come second for fourth year in a row. The 42nd Indian Social Science Congress was inaugurated by Dr. Najma Heptullah, Governor of Manipur at KIIT campus. Okay, now in a big rush to provide credit to micro, small and medium enterprises, the state-owned bank have sanctioned loan worth 14,000 crore under 59-minute scheme launched by the government only last month. And the government is likely to infuse 28,650 crore in 7 PSPs. Its disbursement might even happen before 31st. Okay. The Chaparam or Chariot Festival is celebrated where the public sector bank has approved more than 1.12 lakh loan application. This is over how much crore for MSME under 59 minute scheme. Which state police has made its Malkhana's room for keeping seized arms and ammunition across every police station fully digitized? Say Hu Shagari was the president, former president of which country? Amos Oz was a famous novelist of which country? Let's look at the answers now. The unique Chaparam Chariot Festival that symbolizes the importance of preserving all kind of food and fodder was celebrated with traditional rituals and festivities in the famous Madurai Meenakshi Temple in Tamil Nadu. Okay, public sector bank has approved 1.1 lakh loan MSMEs. And that's worth 37,412 crore. Delhi police is the one which has, you know, inaugurated this e-malkhanas, keeping all these seized arms and ammunition digitized now. Sehu Shagari, Nigeria's second president, whose civilian tenure was sandwiched between two military rulers in an era rocked by coup, has died. He was 93. Nigeria's capital Abuja, currently Nigerian Naira. President Muhammadu Buhari. Amos Oz was Israel's widely acclaimed writer. Okay, so he was a writer, he's from Israel, and the champion of peace, died at the age of 79. Israel currency new shekel, PM Benjamin Netanyahu. Okay, let's try these. Which airline has introduced the world's first single-use plastic-free passenger flight? Now, this is the common trend. Many countries, many places, many organizations are doing away with the single-use plastic. Norman Gimbel of US was famous what? On December 29, PM Modi laid foundation of medical college at Ghazipur in the state. Which state? Where is the headquarter of ESAF Small Finance Bank? Name the plan which Railway Minister Piyush Goyal has announced to keep off elephant from the tracks in Assam. This Portuguese airline High Fly took off from Lisbon on Wednesday without a single piece of single-use plastic on board. This is great news. Norman Gimbel, an Oscar and Grammy Award-winning composer whose lyrics grace hit songs such as Robert Flack's Killing Me Softly with his song and Jim Corsi's I Got a Name Died at the Age of 91. So he was an Oscar and Grammy-winning composer. PM Modi laid the foundation stone of a medical college, Gadipur, in Uttar Pradesh. All right. RBI gave approval to ESAF, Small Finance Bank, to operate as Scheduled Bank, and that is why it was there in the news, and this could be very important, the Small Finance Bank and etc. Just know this is in Thrissur, Chennai. Okay. Railway Minister Piyush Goyal announced honeybee plan in Assam that kept elephants away from the track will be expanded to other areas of the country. It's a simple device that amplifies the recorded sound of honeybees to keep elephants away from the rail track. A simple innovative solution. Okay, let's move to the next. Which toll-free number has been launched by NHRC? Okay, which medical institute has been inducted into Guinness Book for organizing the largest men's health awareness program on prostate cancer on a single day? On December 2019, India has submitted its Dash National Report to Convention on Biological Diversity. The RBI has extended the relaxation offered to the bank for offering liquidity support to NBFCs up to which date in 2019? How much FDI did India receive in 2018 as compared to China's 32 billion? Okay, let's look at the answer. Justice retired H.L. Dattu, the chairperson of National Human Rights Commission, unveiled the toll-free number 14433 at brief seminar ceremony at the Manav Adhikar Bhavan. The state-run MNJ Institute of Oncology and Regional Cancer Center here entered Guinness Book of World Records for organizing largest men health awareness program on prostate cancer. 487 men took part in the awareness program that in the Telangana's capital city, Hyderabad. Okay. The sixth national report to the Convention on Biological Diversity was submitted online to the CBD Secretariat by the Environment Minister, Dr. Harshvardhan. Okay, under the facility to avail liquidity, for liquidity coverage ratio, just know this also, FALLCR, this could be an important abbreviation. Facility to avail liquidity for liquidity coverage ratio. Okay, and this has been extended till 31st March 2019. Okay, India received more than 38 billion in FDIs this year so far when we made this. And it was the first time in 20 years that India has received more FDI than China, according to Dealogic data. Okay, Finding Beauty in Garbage is a documentary film of which state? Which Indian shooter broke the world record of Ukrainian shooter Oleh Omelchuk in 10-meter air pistol? Which country has approved the issuance of first ever renminbi-denominated bonds to raise loans from China's capital market? Exhibition Dandi Yatra, where was it organized? GOI. Has increased the export incentive grant for onion to how much from the earlier 5%. Okay, let's look at this. Finding Beauty in Garbage is a documentary film based on the garbage of Dibrugarh town in Assam. Asian Games gold medalist Saurav Chaudhary won the first men 10 meter air pistol trial with a final round score of 248.2 at the ongoing national shooting trials in New Delhi on December 2019. Okay, so his score was massive, 4.6 point above the present world record of 243.6 set by Ukrainian Oleh Omelchuk. Okay, that was held in Munich. Pakistan cabinet has approved the issuance of first ever renminbi denominated bond to raise the loan from China's capital market. An exhibition Dandi Yatra, this is part of celebration on 150th birth anniversary of the father of nation Mahatma Gandhi, was inaugurated in New Delhi. The government has increased the export incentive granted for onion under the merchandise export from India scheme from existing 5% to 10% in the interest of farmers. Since the prices are going down, if they will export, they will, you know, still make money, and once they export, you know, the quantity will reduce here and the prices will start going up here also. Okay, under which scheme Kyonjhar police has issued 10 postage stamp of Ashok Chakra awardees from police department across the country? Ross Island will now be named as what? On December 29, which state got its permanent battalion of National Disaster Response Force? The main motive of Mahila and Shishu Rakshak Dal under Mahila Police Volunteer Scheme, what is that? Which Indian origin British has been named on the UK's annual New Year's honours? Okay, so the scheme name is MyStamp, under which the Kyonjhar Police in collaboration with Indian Post issued 10 postage stamps, each featuring Ashok Chakra awardees from police department across the country. PM Modi, on his visit to Andaman Nicobar Island, renaming continues, Ross Island as Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose Island, Neel Island as Shahid Dweep, Havelock Island as Swaraj Dweep Island. Okay, so if you want to remember, Ross Bose, right? Neel, freedom fighters, you remember, they were hanged. So what happens? Your body turns blue. Neel is blue. Finally, Havelock is lock, Swaraj is freedom. So lock and freedom. You can just make something like this and you will not forget. Okay, Arunachal Pradesh was given a permanent battalion of National Disaster Response Force. Okay, Ministry of Women and Child Development, Menaka Gandhi holds this portfolio in collaboration with Ministry of Home Affairs, has envisaged engagement of Mahila police volunteers in the State Union Territory who will act as link between police and the community and help women in distress. Award-winning musician and composer Nitin Sohani leads over 30 Indian origin high achiever across different fields, was named on UK's annual New Year's honours. Okay, let's try these. Rinal Sen, who passed away at the age of 95, was what? Named the Indian American teenager who has won digital transformation hackathon at Cornell University. Which country has introduced heat stress scale to prevent tennis player from fainting and exhaustion? In which PSB the Union government will infuse 10,000 and 86 crore, according to RBI report, banks have recovered how much crore from defaulters this year? Okay, so Mrinal Sen, he was the legendary filmmaker, creator of epoch-making films like Mrigya, Bhuvan Shome, Neel, Akasher, Niche, passed away on Sunday. He was 95, suffering from old ailments. Okay, he was the winner of Dada Saheb Phalke and Padma Bhushan. Sen was known for his humanistic approach and his penchant for continuous experimentation, apart from his intense involvement while directing a film. Okay, Mahoum Siddiqui, a 17-year-old Indian-American teenager, recently competed in the Digital Transformation Hackathon, Changing Business, Changing Education, Changing Life competition held at the prestigious Ivy League Cornell University. A new extreme heat policy is at the Australian Open tournament. The central government will infuse around 10,086 crore in Bank of India. Three PSBs, including Bank of India, UCO Bank and United Bank of India, is getting capital infusion to the tune of 28,615 crore this month. In the fiscal ended March 2018, banks have recovered 40,400 crore worth of bad loan as against rupees 38,500 recovered in financial year 17. Okay, let's move to the next. The Huda panel was constituted for what? Which capital city topped the tally in solid waste management in the Swachh Sarvekshan 2018 ranking? United States has adopted two Russian-sponsored resolutions backed by India on what? Who has been re-elected to the Central Council of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India? The provision coverage ratio has gone up from 50% in 2015 to dash in September 2018. Let's look at the answers now. So the panel was set up by government on the recommendation of Defense Secretary Sanjay Mitra about 5 months ago and utilized Lieutenant General Huda's expertise for carrying out a study on the restructuring of the armed forces. So that is your General Huda's. The Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation was awarded Best Capital City in the Solid Waste Management in the Swachh Sarvekshan 2018 ranking. The United Nations has adopted two Russian-sponsored resolutions backed by India on International Information Security System. Babu Abraham Kali Vayalil, a senior chartered accountant from Ernakulam, has been re-elected to the Central Council of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. PSB provision coverage ratio, which means measure of provisioning for bad loans, has gone up from less than 50% in 2015 to 66.85%. as of September 28. What does this mean? Now your profits can cover for almost 66.85% of the bad loan, reflecting improvement in the financial health. The provision coverage ratio gives an indication of provision made against bad loan from the profit generated. Higher the PCR, lower is the unexposed part of the bad debt. Okay.
Okay, so that brings us to the close of this session as well. And as promised, I'll do just one more session, maybe in say a couple of days max. I'll release that banking awareness, which I'm already telling you is already covered here in these four session for the month of December. I'll again segregate. I'll try to make it a little more interesting, because all the business news we tend to be more interested in. Along with that, I'll also put the general news, also some 40-45 questions, and then we will make a session of again 120-130 questions. Okay, so I again see you once more before your clerk exam. Thank you very much. See you again very soon.